Przez 15 lat tańczył taniec towarzyski. Interesuje się sportem, a w jego żyłach płynie gorąca latynoska krew. Przed wami Christian z Hiszpanii. Buenos dias.
Buenos dias.
How are you?
Fine, fine.
How did you come to Poland?
First time in April 2017. Because I was working and living in Fuerteventura, and I met one girl from here, from Gojów, that she was on vacation in January, and we fell in love, and I decided to come to visit, to see how Poland looks like, because I was never before. And I like how Poland is. It's very green and it has a lot of lakes, and what I saw in that moment I liked. Then I came back to Fuerteventura. She came on vacation once again, and everything was going on the good direction, and I came for the whole July. I reached the job here in this Spanish school, and I decided to come to live in Poland because love is love, and you cannot decide what heart is saying, no?
You're from Catalonia. That's a very interesting direction, interesting region in Spain. Can you describe Catalonia?
Catalonia, it's wonderful. It's wonderful. It's on the Mediterranean Sea, on the northeast of Spain. The capital is Barcelona. It totally with the metropolitan area, it's more than 3 million people. It has a lot of things. After that, I'm from the south of Catalonia. That the name of the city is Tortosa. You have the picture there. It's more than 3,000 years of history. My city is little, but quite interesting. I'm from the Ebro Delta. We have two natural important resources, two natural parks, one on the seaside, that is Ebro Delta, and the other that is mountain, that is 1,500 meters, that is Montcaro. And we are in that region that is full of resources, but nobody knows. And this, for me, it's interesting to show to Polish people how it looks like, because Polish people, they are going on vacation to Barcelona, to Malaga, to the most important cities. And for me, my region, it's rich, rich and interesting, but it's not having massive tourism. Then it's nice to go there.
So if somebody wants to go to Spain, you recommend your hometown?
Yeah. My hometown and the Ebro Delta, it's really beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's 14,000 hectares of rice. I don't know how many kilometers of seaside, empty beaches that you are going, next family, it's 50, 60 meters beside you. It's you can say hello from far, no? Mediterranean Sea, warm water, you can swim. Polish people probably can swim from April till October, November. It's warmer water than the Baltic Sea, for sure.
I want to talk about the Spanish culture, you know, because it's very interesting for Polish people, for us. How do you celebrate different celebrations, different fiestas?
We like to go out, we like to meet out of the own house, no? Like here in Poland, if you are having house or apartments, the people starting or going to the house, going to the apartment. We not. We are going out. We like to be on terraces if it's warm. We like to be on clubs, but not starting the party like Polish people when they are going to clubs, that they are starting at 5 p.m. and they are starting drinking vodka. No, no. We are going to have a talk, a conversation with friends. We're having beer. Maybe we are going to a restaurant on the evening because this is not that used as in Spain. To have dinner at 10 in the evening. 10 in the evening, yeah. Here it's closing the kitchen at 10:30, no? There it's closing midnight, we are going to dinner, then we are having, now we are older than before we were going to restaurant, after restaurant club. Now we are going like to chill, to have a conversation with drinks, maybe gin tonic, maybe Cuba Libre, or beer, and after that maybe we are going a little bit on party. But here is different. Here, when you are going out and starting drinking at 5 and you are not having any dinner. And the first time here, I was with my Spanish friend that I met here in Gojów, and with two Polish guys, his friends, no? And we started at 6-7 having beers, and at 9, Álvaro, are we going to eat something? Yes, we are going. Wojtek, Rafa, are you coming to eat? No, we don't want to eat. We just want to drink. And this was what? No, without food I cannot go out. Empty stomach, it's dead.
So on the contrary, we talked about fiesta, and now let's talk about siesta.
Okay? Siesta, siesta.
So do you like practice siesta?
No, I'm not usually having any siesta. I don't like to sleep during the day because on the night I cannot sleep if not. But siesta, it's a stereotype. I think that it's more stereotype. It's siesta time. It's more when it's hot. On summer here in Poland, 30 degrees. Last year it was quite more, no? But in my city, for example, 3 or 4 days last year was 42, 45 degrees. How can you live out of your house on midday? That is the warmest moment on the day. No, we are having part-time jobs, a lot of part-time jobs, working from 8 to 1 or from 8 to 2, having 2 or 3 hours break for food and for relax time. Siesta is included, normal, and after that coming back to work if we are not working on shifts. There are a lot of jobs from 7 to 3, administration, public, from 7 to 3, and they have the whole afternoon, evening free, and they are this kind of fabrica that they are working on from 6 to 2, from 2 to 10, from 10 to 6, and if you are getting out at 2, normally you are eating, and after working hard and eating, you are turning off and putting standby and sleeping a little bit, no?
Can you describe two the most important celebrations in Spain?
The most important celebrations in Spain? I think carnivals are very important, starting from Canadian Islands, are the second most important carnivals in the world, after Rio de Janeiro. But carnival is not just in Canadian Island, it's everywhere, no? We are having it normally in February, and close to my city there are places that is very important carnival. And after that, Halloween, we are going out, or for example, Vielcanots, that is Semana Santa, it's a religious time, and it's important. Or Christmas also, it's a few days that are very important, and the most important day it's Silvester in Polish, that is fin de año, or Cap d'any in Catalan, and this is important day, we are going out to eat and party the whole night.
I want to ask about something controversial, you know?
Okay, let's see.
Let's see, and bullfighting, you know, why is it still popular?
Bullfighting, it's popular in Catalonia, Barcelona, city closed the field, closed the court. It's tradition, it's historic, it's in the history, no? And something that is in the history, you cannot take it out as easy as you think, no? For example, in my place, in my village is 900 people, and we are not having that kind of corridas. We are having like San Fermín. San Fermín is the most important party of cows. It's 7 days, it's in Pamplona, and they are making on the streets, running to the field. It's 1 minute something. And we are having this in little village. We are closing the streets, not big cows, 500, 600 kilograms, like 100, 200, and just running in front of them. Not making any pain to the bull, and we are thinking totally opposite, but this is on the Spanish tradition, on the Catalan tradition, and then we cannot take it out. And I'm from the group, in Catalan is Peña Taurina, I'm from this group in my village, and we are being carefully of all of the process of the bull, no? We are not damaging any cow. They are animals, they have also feelings, I think. Then we protect them. We are just running, having fun. If we are drinking, somebody is going to the floor, and they are little, they are something like this, and they are just pushing you, and you are just having fun from the person that is on the floor, no?
You are a big fan of sport, you know, football.
Yeah.
Football is in your blood a bit.
Yeah. I was playing football almost the whole life, since I was 7 maybe. starting in at school or futsal, then starting also in club in my city. Thanks to the club, we went to Italy. We went to Italy to have a 2 weeks tournament in Italy. My club with by bus, 1,300 kilometers from my city to Turin. I was left when I was 9, 10 years old to with an Italian family, not knowing anything about Italian language, and I started to learn Italian while being there when I was little. And football, it's nice. Maybe they are earning too much now, and it's the economy of football, it's getting crazy. But maybe it's because of the people that they are watching. No.
Are you a FC Barcelona fan or Madrid, Real Madrid?
No, for sure Barcelona. My grandfather brought me to football. He was loving Barcelona, and he taught me how to believe in Barcelona. In bad times at the beginning, we won the first Champions League in 1992, and after that a few years without anything. But if you have Barça in your DNA, you will never change, no? Mm-hmm. It's complicated to change. There are few people that they change because the other team is winning more. No. If I'm from one club, it doesn't matter the victory. If we are losing, I have to be from that club, no?
Have you watched Stilon Gorzów?
Stilon, I went a few times just to watch my nephew, my Polish nephew. He's playing in Stilon. He's the captain for these 3 years that I'm living here. He has always been the captain of the team. He's very smart on the pitch. He's very smart on the life. And he's a really, really nice kid, and they are playing, I don't know the level, because I'm not amongst the level of Polish football or kids, and I'm not watching Ekstraklasa, I'm watching just the Spanish league when I can, because I'm very busy, just Barcelona if I can, and if there is some spare time, I'm watching another match or a few matches, but not Ekstraklasa.
What role does music play in the Spanish culture? It's in your blood.
But not everybody likes to dance. We have the music, we like the music. I'm from Latin music, but we have a lot of discos. Nowadays it's less. They are closing because the young people now, they are more interested on the phones, not going out, but over age, we are going out still, and we love to go to disco, we love to go on clubs, to have party. It doesn't matter if you dance or you don't dance, it's on our blood, I think. Maybe because we are from the warmest country in Europe, and we are Latin, and we have this tradition, but now it's going more to Latin dance like bachata, salsa, and the clubs are changing the styles. I was living in Fuerteventura. In Fuerteventura, it's Latin. I was going on Sundays and Wednesdays in a club, my favorite club that... Oh, these 2 days they were having bachata and salsa and kizomba night, and a lot of people dancing, and this was for me amazing.
And you were dancing, like ballroom dancing, for 15 years.
Yeah.
You were a professional.
More or less. I will never say that I was professional. I'm not living now from dancing. No, my friends are some living from dancing. One of my best friends in dance, that is Edgar Marcos, is Polish champion. He was a Spanish champion, he's Polish champion because he dances with one Polish girl, that is Alina Novak, and they are one of the best couples in the world now.
How about flamenco? You know, this is
flamenco.
Spanish.
Flamenco, it's from the south of Spain, it's from Andalusia. For my competition, there is Paso Doble, it's one of the five dances that I was dancing. It's samba, cha-cha, rumba, Paso Doble and Jive. No, and Paso Doble, it's a Spanish dance. It's representing, we were talking about the bulls, it's representing that the man in that dance is the toreador in Polish, toreros es el torero, and the woman, it can be the bull or the cape, depending on the steps that you are doing in that moment. And it's Spanish dance, and it's talking about bulls and about history. It's Spanish history. En flamenco, and this paso doble, we are having some kind of zapateado flamenco. But I'm not amongst flamenco. It's another kind of dance. Normally, it's more for a gypsy, gitano. It's more dance of gitano, no? And the music is the most important singer was Camarón, Camarón de la Isla. And it's very important in the south of Spain, but in Catalonia, I don't think so.
So now, talking about like dancing, would you like to organize some courses for people in Gorzów?
Yes, the question is time. I love dancing, I love teaching, but I don't have much time, no? I'm busy here at school from Monday to Friday, and also I'm having lessons on Saturday morning and working afternoon evenings when the people is not, they are not working or kids are not on, at school. It's different kind of job, no? If I was working in the morning, would be good for afternoon evenings, have some kind of courses, but I don't have time. Unfortunately, I don't have much time to have this kind of courses.
I want to talk about Spanish food, like gazpacho, sangria, paella. Yes, do I pronounce it well?
Yes. You pronounce correctly everything.
Do you miss the food?
I miss food. Yeah, for sure. It's different here, but I also love Polish food. I also love pierogi. I love Karkówka, everything that contains meat, mainly that contains meat. But good paella, good fideuá, it's not that popular. Polish people, they don't know, but maybe it's more tasty than paella. I love this kind of food. Also prawns. Here you are going to Lidl, they are frozen, very expensive. In Spain, on the seaside where I'm living, you can find this kind of prawns and quite cheaper, no? Then, yes, I miss food. Gazpacho, it's more from Andalusia. For summer it's good because it's cold, it's like soup. You would say in Polish it would be gimnazupa. Gimnazupa zwaziewami?
Dobrze, super.
Would be something like that. And for summer it's good when you are 30 long degrees or 40 degrees and you don't want to cook warm, no? Maybe you are with the Thermomix and drinking, okay, you have power to keep going during the day, no?
What do you eat here, apart from pierogi and karkówka? What's your typical food?
Everything that it's mainly with meat, that contains meat. But pierogi mienza or pierogi piecharkami, this yes, but the sweet, no, I'm not amongst the sweet, no. I prefer to eat karkówka, schabowes ziemniakami, bez koperku. If I don't have time to cook because my schedule is different, I'm going to Domowe, like Czarnaolivka, and always Drugi Danie. It's cheap in Spain. I think you cannot find this kind of restaurants. And it's cheap, fast, and close to the school. Then I eat in 10-15 minutes. I don't have to cook. I don't have to spend time cooking. Money on electricity. And for that money, it's worth it sometimes to go and to have lunch here, no? Polish food is good, it's tasty, it's a lot of meat. There you have a lot of meat. Fish, better in Spain, it's Mediterranean Sea, there are more kind of fishes and fresh fish, but meat, it doesn't matter where. Here, in Spain, schabowe, chicken, you have chicken, you have pig, you have bovina, good, good beef, good food. I gain weight here in Poland.
Mm-hmm. You know, what people like about Spain is tapas, you know, this tapas culture.
Tapas.
What's this?
Tapas, I think it started in the history. I don't remember which king that was going from Madrid, from the kingdom, from the castle, to Andalusia. And by the way, with the carruage, he was going from place to place, a lot of kilometers, and he stopped in like a restaurant from the past, no? And he said, okay, from what you have, I don't want full plates, I want just a little portion of each. Pam, 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 this, 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 and this. The owner of that restaurant or that place put this in few plates, and it became the name of tapas, no? Little portions. And it's tradition, I think a lot of restaurants in Spain we have in the menu tapa, no? Maybe it's patatas bravas, maybe it's calamares, maybe it's tortilla, and little plates in the middle, and we are eating from the middle, not having over and bringing to our plates. No, the tradition, when Polish people comes to Spain, they are like, what are you doing? Eating from the middle, everybody. This is natural, no? This is like this, no? We are eating like the tradition. Then we just have the fork, maybe little plate, and picking from the middle and eating patatas bravas, everybody with the fork from the middle, no? Calamaros, everybody from the middle. If you like with citrina, with lemon, we are splashing the lemon on the calamaros and eating from the middle.
What do you like about Poland? About Gorzów?
Gorzów, it's on hills. My girlfriend told me that it's like on seven hills. It's not ugly city, but they have to finish with the building. Cathedral unfortunately got burned, they have to repair it, but the boulevard, when they will finish, it's beautiful. The city center, when they will finish with the cathedral, will be beautiful. There is big square. Maybe it's not like the other cities in Poland, that they have one Stare Miasto, beautiful, beautiful Stare Miasto. But it's different. It has river, boulevard, it has a square, it has plats on the back of cathedral, and they are making like walking way, not for cars, this main street on where is the city hall, Ujo Miasta. And I think that if Gorzów works, it can be beautiful. Why not? Why not? It has two or three parks. It's not big, like, for example, Poznan, Szczecin, but Gorzów is also beautiful on the point of view after remont, because they are making remont not in one place, everywhere at the same moment. And maybe this is the thing that when you are here, you say, oh, they are building here, building here, building here, never finishing, never finishing. But hopefully when it will be finished, will be really beautiful. New tramway, I saw the other day for first time going, the new tramway. This is also interesting for a city.
Do you want to stay in Poland for the rest of your life?
I don't know the future. I'm always like living carpe diem, and the moment, the present. We don't know about the future. Now my life is in Poland. We are finishing building house. We are already living there. I have a son. I have son, half Polish and half Spanish. Right now he's just Polish because he has just one nationality. Because for the Spanish nationality, I have to go to Warszawa, and it's quite long trip. I love Poland. I love Poland. Poland, it gave me everything. No, it gave me family. The most important thing for a person is to having a kid, Daniel José. The name is Daniel José. And I love Poland, kocham Polska. Kocham Polska, it's like this, it's in my heart. Maybe other people, they will say, are you crazy? No, I'm not crazy, it's what I feel, it's what I think. Poland opened me the arms to live here. I respect this country, I respect the people. I speak a little bit of Polish, making a lot of mistakes. Sorry for my mistakes, but for respect, I want to speak Polish as good as I can.
Powiedz coś po polsku.
Możemy porozmawiać troszeczkę, ale trudno język jest. Trzeci, czwarty, najtrudniejszy na całym świecie.
Mówisz super po polsku.
Myślę, że jest super.
Myślę,
że rozumiem więcej niż mówię. Może być rozumiem 60, 70, 80%, ale mówię mniej. To jest trudno. Deklinacja. Po hiszpańsku nie mamy. Nic nie mamy. Jak może być z Krystianem bez Krystiana? Ale z koperkiem bez koperku. Ta sama deklinacja.
Super przykład.
Nie jest to samo. Mamy A, mamy U, mamy Krystianem, może być Krystian, Krystianem, Krystiana, Krystianowi. Dla nas to jest masakra.
Muszę ci powiedzieć, że jestem pełna podziwu dla twojej deklinacji. Jest super, naprawdę.
Ale nie mam czasu uczyć się, kiedy jestem tutaj i mam dzieci lub osoba, która nie mówi po angielsku. To dla mnie jest challenge, no? Ja próbuję mówić po polsku. To jest Polska, no? To jest Polska. Jestem Hiszpanem, to jest lekcja hiszpańskiego, ale jeżeli nie mówisz po angielsku, ja potrzebuję mówić po polsku i uczyć hiszpańskiego, no? I dla mnie jest challenge. Polski język jest challenge. Ja mówię po katalońsku, po hiszpańsku, po angielsku, po włosku i po francusku. I teraz trochę po polsku. 2 lata i 9 miesięcy w Polsce, ale wszystko jest czas i wiem, że będzie mega. Lubię ten język, jest super inny. Ale kocham, jest si. I to dla mnie jest super.
Zobacz, opowiedziałeś tyle rzeczy po polsku, naprawdę rewelacja.
Ale ja myślę, że 70% nie jest dobrze, ale próbuję, no.
Jest naprawdę dobrze. Ponieważ uczysz hiszpańskiego, może nauczyłbyś nas The only thing I know is despacito, besos,
despacito
besos, you know?
Because of the song, no? Yes. Because of Latin music. Yes. Latin music is very romantic.
Yes.
Very besos, mi amor.
Oh, mi amor,
despacito, siesta, because it's the stereotype, it's not that everybody is having siesta, but mañana, when I came here, Polish people knew that I'm Spanish and they are saying mañana, because they were working with trucks or something and they were going to Spain, and the Spanish companies, if it's our, they are saying mañana, no worries, mañana, and the person from Poland has to wait in the truck for 12 hours to have loaded the truck to go back to Poland. No, mañana, no worries. Polish people, you are hard workers, yes. Spanish people, we have this kind of different thought. If you cannot do it on the moment, think that you can do it tomorrow, mañana. But mañana, it can be jutro and it can be rano. Jutro, rano is mañana por la mañana. Por la mañana or por la mañana, maybe they say por la mañana. And it's by the morning, during the morning, not the utro. This word is controversial, no? Mm-hmm. It's two meanings.
Okay. Firstly, I want to tell you that I like this mañana style. I think I will implement mañana, okay? Teach us something that we can use when we go to Spain, when we want to meet someone, okay? I want to meet the Spanish person.
Okay, so like a presentation, like introduction, yes, to a Spanish person?
Yes.
Hola.
Hola.
It's like Alexandra, okay. Po polsku, ale piszemy przez H. Hola, mm-hmm. Me llamo Cristian, mm-hmm. Soy de España, hola, me llamo
Cecilia,
soy de
Polonia.
Muy bien, soy de Polonia. Tengo 34 años, mam 34 lata.
Okay.
Y soy de Gojów. Hablo muy bien po. Hablo un idioma, dos idiomas. Me gusta España, lo bien hispani. For example, when you wanna go into restaurants, una cerveza, por favor. This is the first words that Polish people wanna know. Piwo po proszę, una cerveza, por favor.
Okay.
If you are in restaurant, when you wanna pay, la cuenta. Por favor, normally I'm always saying, por favor, being cordial with the person that is working, no? If you are cordial, they will treat you cordially. Always, por favor.
Muchas gracias. We have a lot of information about Spain. Muy bien, Cristian.
Muchas gracias por la entrevista también. Ha sido algo interesante, muy interesante, formar parte de un proyecto. Y espero que tengáis más gente de otros países. Por ejemplo, si puedo haceros llegar el contacto de una persona de Portugal o una persona de Francia, intentar ayudar. Siempre es bueno hacer ver que no hay en Gojów solo gente de Polonia o de Ucrania, que es un país muy cercano a Polonia. Hay más nacionalidades. Muchas gracias por todo también.
Muchas gracias por todo también. Is it correct what I said?
Muy bien, sí.
Thank you so much. And yes, and I hope that a lot of people will visit your hometown and a lot of people will visit Spain right now.
Hopefully. Tortosa and the Ebro Delta, it's amazing, really beautiful, really beautiful place. Go ahead.
I have one last exercise for you.
Okay.
This is my magic bowl, you see, with the questions. Can you choose one question?
I love red color.
Okay, I can see.
Do you know any famous artists from Gojów? Yes. I know one singer that the name is David. David is like the Polish Justin Bieber.
Yes.
I don't remember now. I don't remember. I totally forgot the family name, but he was like judging the boys' kids. And I also know from Jugel, I know Bartosz Szmaslik.
Super.
Because he's everywhere. And he was the last world champion, no? Yes. I know a few, no?
Okay. That was David Kwiatkowski.
Fiatkowski, tak.
Perfect, super. Dziękuję bardzo. Thank you so much.
Dziękujemy.
Gracias.
De nada.
Dziękujemy bardzo i do zobaczenia albo na lekcjach hiszpańskiego z Krystianem, albo w Hiszpanii. Adios.
Adios.